first time live at the National Aquarium, and they're hoping you'll be able to spring ahead with some of their fun exhibits right now. Kristen Frizzell is here with me, and something people might already be hearing in the wild because it's becoming spring is this animal. I'm going to play the sound it makes. And it's not a bird, it's a frog. And what is that frog called?
So the sound of that vocal that you heard is from our spring peepers, which are starting to come out now that spring is approaching. So they're very, very loud. They do sound like birds, but I can assure you that that beautiful sound is our spring peepers. It can be heard up to a mile to 2.5 miles away.
Oh, wow. And look how cute they are. Oh my God, they are just so cute and tiny.
Yes, they're very, very small, but they can leap very, very far. So frogs are known for their ability to leap very far, so they can leap up to 20 times their body length here.
Oh my God, yeah, one almost escaped before we got into the segment, so they know how to jump. Okay, now this here is a toad, and what makes a toad different from all frogs?
So a toad is a frog, but not all frogs are toads. So some of the differences that you can see with the frogs and toads is that frogs are going to have a more rounded body, whereas frogs are going to be more slender. Okay. Frogs are also more in the wet environment, so they like it a little bit damper. They have very damp skin, whereas toads are going to be more dry. They're going to live in drier climates and habitats. So they also do more of a hopping, whereas frogs do more of leaping.
Oh, yeah. Okay, good to know. I didn't know that. So not all frogs hop. Some of them leap.
Yes.
Okay, good.
Yeah. And also, now that spring is approaching, if you check out your backyards, your streams, you can start to see some of the toads laying their eggs. They lay their eggs in a string-like pattern, whereas frogs are going to be more clumped together.
Wow, that is so interesting. What makes it so great about the National Aquarium is that you have a lot of these frogs that are local to the area, but you have them in a box that's easy to see. Out in the yard, it's a lot harder to catch them.
Absolutely. So come on down and check out some of our animals up close and personal, but also feel free to check out nature and listen to some of those awesome sounds that the spring animals are starting to make.
Good. Let's play that again. So, Tony, that's a spring peeper there. Here's the American toad. Let's see if I can get it. So are you a toad or a frog today?
You know you've heard that sound coming out of the weather office. That's how I let you know I'm here in the morning when you show up at 4 o'clock.
Are you hopping or leaping through your day?
I'm leaping, of course. You know this.